And I've convinced some people who are not sober, who are alcoholics, to not drink alcohol, and they then report their activity in the bedroom and their pleasure and their dopamine highs are so much more exquisite compared to when they think, and most guys think this too, oh, I got to have a drink to relax, to be able to talk to this lady. Or the ladies think, I got to have a glass of wine or two or three or four to be able to, you know, basically have the excuse in our puritanical society to engage in pursuing a man or making love with a man or woman or whatever it is. But the point is that these hormones, and I think it's eloquently explained in this book, and I kind of reviewed it in great detail, because when I wrote my book, Mastering Love, Sex, and Intimacy, I went through 26 years of research on hormones and sex and relationships and intimacy. And I questioned my own theory that I had in the book. So I restrained myself from publishing the book until Valentine's Day. And when I finally published it, I had validated and verified everything that I thought was true in that book. And that book I was sharing with a client a couple weeks ago. I don't know if you've read the book yet or not.
Not yet.
We'll get you a copy. I think I have one left in the office. They all sold out, which is nice. You can order them still on Amazon. But the point is, John Gray endorsed the book. I've been on several love sex panels where John Gray was present. He's obviously one of the great relationship
coaches. Men are from Mars and women are from Venus, right?
Yes. And I know John Gray from as early as 1994. Mm-hmm. He and I shared the stage working with Tony Robbins. So that takes us back, you know, a good 30 years back into life, right? And when you think about how long he's been working in the relationship field, and he agrees that I'm one of the experts in understanding hormonal and relationship issues.